Hello peeps, just to let you know, we are live on stream, so, you know, keep it tame. Getting things set up.
Hello.
Hello everyone.
Hi people on the stream.
Hello peeps.
Good morning.
Just to let you know,
Oh no.
So, why is it doing this? You know, keep it tame.
How much time before we start?
So 10 minutes.
Pretty much as I get set up.
I love the new
place you'd like everybody to meet.
User joined your channel. I'm gonna restart real quick so I can turn off mechanism sounds.
All right. Why do I have a random, almost broken bow in my hand? Oh, because I was killing skeletons.
Good morning.
Howdy.
Morning, Glitch.
My bow and my primal one focus are ready.
Oh boy.
I will try not to one-shot people.
Yeah, remember, friendly fire is on. Try not to kill each other.
That doesn't Unless sound friendly at all.
It's just a love Balog. Tap. A 50 heart love tap.
Balog, have you got some beer so we can sit down somewhere and drink it while these guys go off to battle?
You know what I need now? I need to get, like, a mod that has a palanquin in it so that I can have four of you haul me into the fight in direct traffic as you guys go and kill the dragon for me.
That would be hilarious.
Yes.
That probably
Especially
exists,
if only three of them could fly.
The last one's just dangling from it.
You could always use the, flying monkeys. Just summon you up to the flying person.
Someone stole my crops again.
I'm not at flying monkeys yet.
It's been like 2 weeks since I had someone steal crops. But they've done it.
Resith, you're the only person that has reported any theft issues at all. We're trying to track it down, but they're not showing any... Like, we haven't been able to find any player interacted with crops events in the logs for anyone that isn't you in your area.
And it makes me wonder where they're vanishing to then.
Well, I do know that Endermen will sometimes pick up crops. Is it a whole bunch of crops, or is it just like a few here and there?
Like a few here and there.
Okay, well, the
I've been
Endermen,
barely on the
like...
last couple of days, and one plot, I explicitly took every last seed off and put them all back in. And one of them is missing from it. And there's just a dirt block in one of the other, the old plots now.
And the other thing is the pigmen will stomp on them too. So if you have,
I don't have a portal,
other portal nearby.
I'll just use OJ's one because otherwise I'd be way too close. They'll just get tangled up anyway. And I really don't want to spend, like, however many minutes it does, so it takes to untangle it.
But yes,
I've
been lazy into the theft issues.
However many minutes, yes.
Well,
what are you doing with my pick ever?
Spend like 10 minutes untangling the portal, or I could just jump over to the other portal, which is 10 seconds away.
At the moment, trying to find you to give it back. I needed grass.
Yeah, why does everybody keep eating a grass block?
I'm making
I'm in the
seeds to go to spawn. If we're doing it at spawn anyway.
Yeah, where would you like us to meet, PM?
Spawn's a good place to set up a community. You've got the, you guys have, like, the community portal room thing with the teleposers, right?
Yeah, we have the Nexus.
Okay. Is that at spawn, or is there a link there from spawn?
Actually, I don't think there is a spawn there
yet.
Well,
we can't mess with anything around spawn because it's protected. So, no, I don't think so.
Yeah.
Okay, well, Saf, do you want to get one of those set up so that there's a link to the Nexus from spawn?
Yeah, I can do that. I'll just set up another command block for that.
Okay. Alright. We're getting things together. Beastie plays everything. All the information you need is in the FAQ. Easiest way to get to spawn when I am quite a long way away from spawn is going to be for me to make some world seeds from Batania, which are just some dragonstone, wheat seeds, and grass blocks. Except I'm low on dragonstone, of course, because why wouldn't I be? How do I not have any resources available today? It's been a week of stress is why. Wow, I don't even have any diamonds. Do I at least have diamond essence? Kinda. I'm sure there's someone to blame for this. Wow.
Suffering.
Me.
Lots of followers. Thank you very much, everybody, for following. Let me actually get T-board on my screen so I can see who is following. In just the past 10 minutes, we have had Nannerman321, Kenya00, Stonewaves, and BillyBib123032. Thank you very much. Appreciate that greatly. Give me mana diamonds. Alright, portal. Be a portal for me for a little bit. What am I doing on mana pearls? They're okay. Greenwood, okay. Elementium. Low. And I'm gonna need a bunch of sky stone while I'm at it too, so might as well toss a stack of living rock through there. And that can give some people some time to filter into the stream while we wait for all of the materials to come back out of this.
I just turned off mechanism sound, so there's no filter noise.
Three aspects.
Montagar's asking if I am alright as I look more tired than the fire alarm vlog. I am, actually. There's been a lot of stress over the past month or so, and I need to do a vlog about it. Just stuff. But today is going to be a fun day. There's going to be a bunch of streaming. We're going to do Minecraft now. And later on, we might end up streaming from the PS4, some Last of Us Remastered, because that was available at Best Buy this morning. So we went and picked it up and had a nice breakfast together, Apollo Cat and I did. But yeah, I may look very tired, but I'm honestly okay. And they've got me on, new blood pressure medication, which is always fun to figure out. So take some time to adapt to that.
You can borrow my ogling device.
Speaking of, since I already forgot once today, this is your daily take your meds requirement reminder.
Yes.
Yes, I renamed it.
Everyone, take your pills. And in preparation for getting proper medication from the psychiatrist and such, I've gone off of my home custom blend of St. John's wort and a handful of other herbs and such, which is just making motivation and energy levels very low right now. But you need to go off of that stuff for a month or so before you start taking proper SSRIs or SNRIs from a psychiatrist, or you might end up with a fairly deadly condition known as serotonin storm. You don't want that.
I admit that I haven't heard that one.
So if you have, it's especially common if you're taking MAOIs, and SSRIs is where they learned that you, can't be taking two antidepressants at the same time. But yeah, you will, in fact, destroy your own brain through too much serotonin and too much neural activity if you're taking multiple antidepressants at the same time. And you will get, a nasty fever, be really nauseous, have hot flashes all over, and then just kind of, your metabolism goes on overdrive and you burn up from the inside out.
That sounds pretty nasty.
Yep, it's not good.
Oh wow, is that the chakram?
Hmm? Yeah.
I have not seen the chakram before.
I'm ready to sell some tech stuff.
Oh yeah, Crunksplane also says that it can take up to 6 weeks for SSRIs to take a full effect. That is absolutely true. You need to give it a long time for your blood serum level to reach therapeutic levels. It's a pain in the butt. That's what it is. Yay, I've got new pills, so it'll make me feel better. Sometime. Next month.
Eventually.
Yeah. But when they do kick in, they're really good.
Of course, that particular serum level problem is especially noticeable if, like me, you weigh 500 pounds.
Yeah, that's a problem. I'm about 350 myself, so.
Okay, these garden lanterns are really pretty.
Yes, they are.
Need to get some seeds before I can actually get make the stuff that I need to get to you guys.
We did have a werewolf in the house.
Sara has done an excellent job on the Nexus.
Oh, awesome. Yeah.
The Nexus is beautiful.
I need to get either Sara or you, Barlock, to come help me do the my rebuild of the lab, because I've just had cracked sand walls here for like a week or two now, and I need to fix that. It's terrible.
Anytime you wish me.
Why should you be any different to anyone else?
Because I've got minions that can make pretty things for me.
Did you not miss, did you miss his thing where we need to get a carriage and carry him around?
That's what winged monkeys are for, isn't it?
Yeah. That would be like the ultimate use of winged monkeys would be to have a palanquin that could carry them there. Is there any good way for me to set something up to, like, besides the teleposer to get myself back here? You know what? I can make the trip in the Nether pretty easily from where spawn is. That'll be a fun adventure to get back home.
You have your own room in the Nexus.
Yeah, but I haven't actually set anything up for blood magic yet, and I don't want to just leech off of what the server is doing because I'm stubborn and want to do my own thing.
I was actually thinking about using command blocks for yours, because I know that they set up the teleposers, but with the command blocks, I can actually make it specifically so they only work for you.
Oh, okay. Oh, wow, you get four
There's
world seats.
There's one door in the place, anyway.
Four world seats from each of these. That's kind of cool.
Well, crates can move people. Can carry on you with it.
But yeah, the world seed from Batania is pretty much just a town portal, effectively. It takes you back to the spawn of the world.
Lord of Hell.
If you are further than 24 blocks from world spawn point, using the seed via right click will instantly teleport you there, consuming the seed. So, let's go back to spawn. Oof.
So, how did everybody get big?
Nice.
OJ's throwing potions at people.
Alright, and there's a... Wow. Spawn has changed since the last time I was here. It was just a little shack. Now everyone, it's like pretty darn nice out here. Is this Barlock?
Yep.
Okay. Okay, I like the well with the kettle over top of it. That's adorable.
Inside is a Nexus sign with a command block underneath it, and we also have the spawn too for the new people.
Could we actually, hang on. Oh yeah, you already did set it up with pressure plates. I was going to say, could you set it up in the world with a pressure plate? Yeah.
Yep.
And
I use the netherrack ones because they only happen for people.
Okay. And where's the, netherrack? There's a netherrack specific
pressure plates.
Pressure plate?
Yep. Well, we have the Nexus one over here.
Oh.
And
from the Nature mod, right. Okay. I forgot about that. I forgot they added a bunch of custom pressure plates. I just always end up using the carpenters or the arcane so that you can set it up yourself.
Right.
Alright, let's go check out spawn 2. Not nearly as nice.
That's because I did it.
We should get someone out here to make spawn 2 pretty. But yeah, having a little welcome to the new continent. I see someone is building what looks to be a skyblock over there. Has just decided, you know what, I'm going to build a platform that you can only access by ladder that goes out over the water. That's fine.
We have a few of those.
Oh, okay. Well, I mean, it's one way to stay safe. ish.
Except direwolves don't really care about that.
Eh. They don't seem to spawn on grass for me. At least I haven't had any spawn in my base because most of it is grass, I think.
I found a direwolf on the second floor of my mansion.
Is your base wasteland biome?
Yes. Most of it. A very tiny part of it is now magical forest because of the latest episode that just went up this morning.
Now, if you were to go north, you would see Barlock's lighthouse, too.
Well, today we're not doing a server tour stream. We will definitely do one of those in the future, maybe next weekend. I'm thinking I might start doing... Oh, wow. This is a really cool Nexus. We might start doing, like, some regrowth server stream stuff every weekend.
Yeah. I'm the only one here who's not wearing Terra Steel.
Because it's good armor?
No, there's quite a few of them that are wearing LM2.
I'm wearing some comparable, but still. I feel like the odd one out.
Oh, don't worry. We'll get your armor soon. Or prettier armor.
Actually, you know what? Just doing what someone, whoever at the top layer has done, and setting an arcane door on their little entryway.
Yep, I have keys for you too.
Oh, that is mine.
Yours.
I see.
That's yours.
You can tell I haven't been doing a whole lot with the, like, multiplayer part of the server yet. Alright, we gotta see. Geronimo! That is not my Rod of the Skies. There we go. There's just a pile of chests full of redwood leaves down here. That is amazing.
Yes, the tree hasn't finished being built.
And a very long carpenter's ladder. Ah.
All work on the greenhouse has been put on hold for a while.
Oh?
It's Sora's build.
Oh, okay. That's fair.
Yeah, that one I showed you.
Morning security cones patrolling. Cute.
Yep.
Yep. One of these days, I will have to do an actual, like, proper server Let's Play where I do more community stuff, but I don't know. I just get, especially when I'm trying to do a HQM-style pack, I want it to be kind of in the Agrarian Sky style that I did originally, which means me going through everything bit by bit. I'm just antisocial is what it really is.
We know.
It's fun.
Sora made the tapestries in each room different so that you could tell the difference.
Yep, they're cool.
I'm in the end.
Yeah, the Nexus is a Sora and Geert project.
Neat.
He's been doing all the Thaumcraft and blood magic stuff.
Cool.
Okay.
Why was I suddenly in my...
That happened to you too.
Me too.
Me too.
Huh.
That was strange.
Wait, what happened?
It seems like everyone here was just suddenly in their travels gear inventories for some reason.
Yeah, that was odd.
A bit.
Tashi right. Uncovered our portal and I just accidentally
And it's happening again.
In.
Why does it keep happening?
Why is this happening?
Oh, I have no idea.
Too many travelers in one place?
Maybe. Beastie Plays MC, I do not know what mod pack I'm going to do next. But I expect to be working on this one for a good bit longer.
I forgot about the teleporter.
You know what I completely forgot to get was, like, the, portals and such. Whoops.
Did you remember a bow?
Yeah.
I have no clue where I am.
Alright, so... I'm going to pop back to... Oh, you said you have keys for me, Saf?
Yes, to get up into that place, but we'll need to set that up another time.
Oh, okay. Never mind then. Let's see. Put my coordinates down here somewhere. Hang on, I will be right back. What?
Suddenly I'm back a spore instead of a statue.
Ender essence. Alright, so to make an ender portal with magic crops, it's just 9 ender essence in a big block formation. I don't want, like, 9 of them. Because I want to actually build something for this.
How does OJ have 95 hearts?
He's a werewolf.
Oh.
He's a talented who's throwing werewolf. Those potions?
Huh?
Who's throwing the big potions?
OJ.
OJ's showing off, huh? We have a whole bunch of new followers. Thank you very much, MC Gamer 1978, Flamingo 200, Chief the Gamer, Barry Ash, Colin 5314, FMA Winry, yay Winry, and WTF Data. Ooh, all right. Yeah, that'll do. Back to World Spawn. And then to the Nexus.
Do I grow while I'm sitting on the bench?
That's frustrating.
It's lagging.
Yeah, I think all of the player growth stuff is an issue for some people. Do I have any random extra blocks with me? Of course I don't. That would be like planning or something. That's okay, we can just use some of these pipes that I'll never use for anything else. Alright, so I'm adding a nether portal to the Nexus, but to get, not another portal, an ender portal. But to actually get into it, you're gonna have to do a bit of a leap of faith.
Okay.
Oh god.
What if I have no faith?
Well, you're in trouble.
Have faith in Mentat.
If you take the, levitator all the way to the top floor, you will see the end portal frame I'm putting together. If you don't already have flight, which if you're starting new, you won't be able to get until after you've been to the end and helped kill the Ender Dragon once, or, you don't necessarily have had to have helped kill the Ender Dragon, but you have to at least get there once. And you want to take this free portal? Well, you're gonna have to, go to the top of the tree and hurl yourself off into the portal.
You want us to take our flight off? Because we can. I'll wear my tiny potato mask instead.
Nice. Yeah, I ended up removing my own tiara because the tiara now requires you to have the Ender Air bottle. In fact, you know what? I should probably have brought some bottles with me to make some of those, considering that is the entire purpose of this. You can tell that I'm all kinds of prepared and have had lots of time to get all of this set up.
Otherwear infusion.
Game year 28 and FM... N Famedo? Sure, why not? Thanks for following.
Joined your channel.
Hello, user.
Hello.
Hello.
Hey, looking.
Quick Poisons is asking if I'm going to do the blood magic self-sacrifice or normal sacrifice. I've done the normal, like, kill everything else thing twice. I might do self-sacrifice just this once. Alright. So, let us head for the end. I'm coming up to the top of the tree now, and we're gonna hurl ourselves in there. PJ2 Official X, I have been announcing it on my channel for the past multiple days. So, yes, it's been announced on, like, every video for the past three, and has been announced on Twitter. So, I apologize if that's not enough notice, but that's all I'm going to give. ATOG 2074, I expect this probably will be a 10-second dragon kill. Oh, and we're inside a mass of bodies, which is not all that close to the platform. Well, I hope people will either bring a bunch of obsidian or a bunch of endstone when they want to get over there. But that's why I have my Rod of the Skies. Properly managed, it will get you where you're going.
Tashi.
Alright, let's go kill some of these pylons and then deal with the dragon. Who even needs tinkers anyway?
Just bear in mind, the rainbow particles are me.
Yeah, that's one of the rods that I was thinking I should have brought for this, and was planning on taking care of it. I think I just accidentally blew someone up that was at a pylon a little.
Are you ready to go? Or did
look
I
at that.
I was actually referring
to we're already
the fact
going.
I have a primer one focus.
Everyone get in here.
Probably don't want to hit like that.
Now, who is it? Everlost is flying through here with the rod of missile barrage or whatever it is.
I have a bow.
I'm randomly firing arrows at the group that is flying around. Oh wow, Ender Dragon just lost like 3/4 of its hit points. It slowed down enough for people to catch up with their melee weapons. There it goes.
Yay.
Yep.
Woohoo!
All right.
Easy. Okay. With the atomic assembly, it was really easy.
Yeah, I'm getting XP.
Okay, so I was wrong about 5 seconds.
Yeah, it took slightly longer than that.
It didn't even get destroyed.
Of course not. Why would they need to be?
Did anyone remember to bring a piston?
Who needs a piston?
No.
Collecting dragon eggs 101 over here.
Torch.
Put a torch underneath it, then break the block it's standing on.
Remember everybody to get their
air. Some mod packs disable that.
Well, yes, but that's like non-vanilla behavior, so. Alright, and the reason we came here in the first place. Bottles of Ender Air.
No, I don't have my dolly. Atashi, don't break it.
What? What are you doing?
Nothing.
What are you doing?
Explosions.
That is really cool to watch from outside, Everlost.
Hip, I have a dolly.
Oh. I need a crystal that isn't exploded.
That's what, Mentat? I was trying to pull them away from you so it wouldn't be loud.
It's really cool to watch from outside. Just everyone's here destroying lots of Endermen now and such. That primal wand focus.
I'm just scanning people.
Yeah, kind of flashy.
One of the few ranged weapons that can actually affect an Enderman is the Batania Terra Blade and some of the rods from Batania.
I forgot about my Terra Blade.
Ow. Ow. Cut it out. Alright. This was a good time, folks. Even if it was very, very fast. Maybe we should do a challenge event for them sometime. What do you think?
Yes.
Reset the end. Reset the end, come back, and everyone gets to be armed with, we'll put up, like, an infinite barrel of snowballs. Leave your armor at home.
You can only use iron.
Taint. Whoops. Glad this place gets reset because I've suddenly created a taint farm.
Oh dear. All the ender pearls, all the levels.
Looking, there's ender hives out here.
Well, our end's going to be covered in taint now.
Yeah, that's one of the reasons that we're going to need to reset it frequently is the ender hives.
Yes.
Make it full of taint.
Back in one moment, folks.
Lucan is one of the crazy people who actually enjoys bees.
Bees are amazing.
What's wrong with bees?
How about that?
Did I scare you?
Oh, no, I just got back. I sneezed and had to go. Huh, camera tracking is actually functioning. That's fun. I didn't think it would. All right.
All right, time for me to go ahead and steal this giant obsidian pillar.
Anza, if your problem is I don't have, I'm not partnered, then so long, sayonara, good riddance, don't come back. Sorry if I'm not very forgiving on that, but there's nothing I can do about it, and it's not my fault. So blaming me is not exactly going to help anyone. I got absolutely no patience for people being less than kind today. Not after the drama that's been going on this week. Alright, so because I would like this to be a little bit longer of a thing for the special that I want to put out tomorrow, we're gonna head home.
And then
do some other work back there, I think. Back to, oh, yeah. End of the game. Oh, that's right. It actually pops you back to your bed. Nice! So now I actually have a way to go to spawn and then take the thing to the Nexus and then ride the guy to the top.
What the hell? Random aggressive Enderman. That's hilarious.
Oh sure, someone put a plank here to walk off of into the end portal. That's no fun.
Well, it's no fun without a Jolly Roger in the background, at least.
You need to walk the plank.
Uh-oh.
My home bed was missing or obstructed. Yay.
Whoops.
I told you to sleep in it before you left.
I've already slept in it like 10 times.
Sleep more.
But it's okay. We have the instant travel to the Nexus.
Poof. And yep, this gets me back home. Awesome. Nice. Now I have a... Oh, I am out of... I am completely and utterly out of food and now getting damaged by the fact that I'm starving. Okay, so now that we have the Ender Air bottle, we could actually make the tiara. So I'm going to allow myself to use that again, thankfully. Yay! Oh, right, it doesn't function at all unless it's in your amulet slot, does it?
Nope.
With mana.
I have mana. Oh, there was a slight server derp or something. It didn't notice that I put it on. There we go.
Since the Ender Dragon is done at the moment, could I borrow you at the Nexus PM?
Oh, certainly. I guess he has other things for me. Well, now that I have a way to get between home and the Nexus fairly easily, as long as I keep remembering to make more world seeds, this will be good for now. I am now at the Nexus. What's up, Seth?
Second floor.
Second floor. Okay. Ah, there we go.
Yep, use that on the door and you'll have full access.
Mm-hmm. So, arcane doors are something that come out of Thaumcraft. I haven't researched them yet myself, but they can be found in Artifice. Right here, Warded Arcana. When you build an arcane door, the only people that can use it, if you set the mode properly by, I believe it's shift right clicking with your wand, You can set it so that only people that are keyed to it can use it. The gold arcane key, I believe, allows you full access to all features of it, including the ability to make more keys to give to other people.
Just a correction, right-clicking it with your wand breaks the door.
Oh, okay. There, I know that there's a way to cycle it through different modes. Or maybe that's only the trap door.
I'm pretty sure it's just the pressure plate.
Oh, well, fine. It's been a while. I always re-reference these things before I explain them, usually. But, okay, and now we've got the teleposition focus and the teleposer from Blood Magic, which we'll definitely make use of once I have a better place for Blood Magic, I think. The teleposer requires the teleposition focus to craft, and the teleposition focus is just a tier 4 altar, so it's not that tough to get, but yeah. Ooh, Kalyan is telling you to start YouTube, Saf, because your voice is amazing.
Okay, well, thank you.
Yeah, just a correction, Saf's because I've broken amazing. My door too many times.
That's fair.
Anybody have any tunnels they need, Doug?
Oh? In a tunneling mood?
Well, I have this lovely, indestructible glowstone hammer that's really fast.
Ha!
And
fair.
I built it after I no longer had any need to dig tunnels.
I see.
Stop the train line.
If somebody wants to point me at where to start, I will happily do that.
I reckon Y level 8 looks good.
Y level 8? Yeah, let me head that way.
And, well, work out where the closest base is and start going that way.
Right. So I can't actually make use of these until I have an LP network because these are not bound to someone else yet. So we're just going to leave those there. And once I have Blood Magic started up, which will be sometime soon, to get into Blood Magic, you need a little bit of Batania going, I believe. I don't think there's much in the way of Thaumcraft. You need
Thaumium ingots for the altar, and that's about it.
Yeah, that's exactly what I mean by just a little bit of Thaumcraft. And there isn't much in the way of questing for it yet, so I've been laying off until there was, but unfortunately it doesn't look like it's going to be available, the quest for Blood Magic, for quite some time. So, yeah. Alright, so for the time being, we will just send ourselves home the way that we have available to us. The legit way, since I've already cheated myself home enough times.
Now, when you say the legit way, do you mean by right-clicking on your witch's hand so that you can teleport back to a safe spot?
Nope. That's another way that I have not set up yet. I haven't built much in the way of travel yet. Anytime you go through the portal that the dragon leaves, in the end, you're returned to your spawn point.
Which is convenient unless your spawn point is very carefully protected by being inconvenient.
And just in case you're wondering, that building is also entirely warded.
I assumed it must have been, or it wouldn't have made a lot of sense.
Oh, we have warded on the nether side, too.
Excellent. You guys really went out of your way to build something very safe. Thank you.
Welcome.
Yep.
All I really contributed is repeated attempts to break into it, admittedly, but still.
Yeah, well, you need to test for failure.
Well, there is this one focus, which lets you basically do what the Staff of Traveling does, I think.
Yes. There are a handful of travel options that I have not looked into at all yet. Honestly, with the Tiara, I'm pretty much happy. This is more than enough for local travel.
Really?
That reminds me, I need to make a portable hole.
Portable hole is a lot of fun.
Yeah, those are. Two things. One, I'm going to summon a demon real quick.
Okay.
As long as nobody objects. I don't think you'll be able to hear it, but I can never be sure.
The regular witch is demon, you can't.
It's a blood magic demon.
Oh, okay.
The other thing was, as long as everyone and their cousin is on, I wanted to see who was still interested in possibly participating in starting up the Convocation of the Damned.
That's definitely going to be another
second, but
it's going to be another server event we'll do sometime. Let's target another Saturday, a week or two from now, for that.
Okay.
I want to get some blood magic done. I want to get to the point where I could do that before we start that, you know?
Yeah, absolutely.
Looks like we did hear it.
Yep, yes, we did.
That was somebody summoning the wither, not me.
Yeah, I'm actually far enough away. Okay. I didn't hear a darn thing, so... by the way, when you do get your hands on a dragon egg, and there are more than one way to get a dragon egg besides just killing the dragon, though the end will likely still continue to reset somewhat regularly. The other options are the dragonfish from Mariculture, which is a real pain to breed, or draconic chunks from magic bees, which come out of draconic dust, which come from the draconic queen, which is a lot easier to beat than the friggin' fish. But
the
dragon egg will crank up your altar by a good bit, as you can see. Like, I think I just gained 2,000 power on my times 6 altar by putting that down. Let's double check.
Actually, I believe it provides a lot of power because it's the way to have a, basically a
portable.
Yes, a portable altar.
Well, the altar itself is currently at 9890. I put the dragon egg down next to it, and it jumps up to 11140.
I was looking around when I was trying to make the, death protection poppets. Apparently, the whole system changed with the altar, so it's now actually somewhat necessary to have large amounts of power in it.
Yes. That's why I'm happy to have over 11,000.
Yeah, but... Okay.
I was reading on one Reddit thread mentioned that you needed, like, 12,000 power to summon the last boss they added.
That's an intense amount. Alright.
Okay, now I'm triggering the demon.
Okay.
This will take 2 seconds.
Yay!
I hope.
Alright, so I suppose the next step is actually to get a little bit more alchemy done. We need to make some Essentia distillation stuff to make the golems as simple as possible. Well, let's see.
You said Y level 8 for the tunnel?
I like Y level 8. Other people like Y level 13 or so. Don't know why. But I tend to build my tunnels at Y level 8.
I like withers.
No, you don't, because you keep killing them. If you like them, you just invite them over and let them stay.
He loves them to death.
Repeatedly.
I have just accidentally discovered that you can spawn a fallen angel with their head in the ceiling.
The Thaumcraft entry for the one focus blink.
Just beautiful, huh?
The only thing that sucks more than getting up is having to walk places. So much work!
Uh-huh.
What's the point of being a big fancy magician if you still have to use your feet like everyone else?
Can't confirm.
That's why I like my witch's hand.
With the parting line of, now all you need is a shower focus and you'll be all set.
Nice.
I'm infused to otherwhere, which allows me to teleport all over the place. I even have a recall function.
Yep. Yes. I need to get into infusion soon, but right now I'm doing Thaumcraft. 7 and 8 is 15, and 4 is 19. What was that about Thaumcraft?
There's so much stuff in it.
Uh-huh.
Add-ons. Gotta love them.
Very much.
I like Thaumcraft an awful lot.
And two of my favorite new add-ons are Thaumcraft NEI plugin and Node Tracker. If anybody of you don't even know we have Node Tracker, just hit I. You'll see it.
I gotta say my favorite add-on right now is actually Witching Duels, because it gives you that gloriously beautiful search bar on your Thaumonomicon.
It doesn't work.
Works fine for me. You can only search things you've already researched.
Oh.
Just a heads up, because there's banks in Witching Gadgets, don't bother with them because they're small. Except for the Void Link bag, which is basically a dev null.
Okay. We need to get this thing filled up. Wait, what's that? Ah, it's a baby zombie pigman on a chicken.
Yeah, yeah, one of those. Tried to get eggs out of it, but then I found out that you can't actually get eggs off of those ones.
Yep. I think I want to, part of me is really tempted to make an, what do you call it? A name tag. Keep him around. Everyone needs a pet, right? I'd probably end up accidentally killing it somehow.
Oh, that makes me wonder. Do you have to name tag the chicken and the baby zombie, or just one or the other?
I have no idea. Be perfectly honest. Oh, you know what?
One of these days I'm going to catch one of those creepers riding a spider.
Yes.
It's like, put it behind a water glass screen with the tagline, death. With legs. Many, many legs.
Ah, the arrow doesn't seem to be working for me. From the, little map. The Thaumcraft node tracker.
The Thaumcraft node tracker has an interesting sort of problem. It, no matter how far up or down you scroll, the buttons on the side only point to the same nodes that are on the first page.
I don't have that many nodes. I'm trying to select literally the very first node.
Goodness.
Just hit
that's
the
strange.
Mark button.
Yeah, I am pressing the mark button, and nothing is happening.
What?
Bummer.
Huh. Well, obviously, it's decided that it can't work because you don't have enough nodes for it to mess up properly.
What it might be is if you haven't scanned that node since we updated. It
no,
may
I
have patched
scanned
out.
It yesterday.
Well, never mind then.
Possibly the problem is you've got like 6 people telling you what could be wrong.
That must be it.
No, everyone's got always has like a theory, and I'm sure that this is the problem. But interesting.
Well, if it's the problem is that 6 people are telling you, I can come up with a reason and tell you and make it 7, so it'll fix the issue.
Yes.
Or
lucky,
is it saying
lucky,
it's
lucky
6
seven.
With another person saying about the 6? Does it just go
it's because you don't have a frog leg from witchery. That's it.
Ah, yes, of course.
What it is, you need to have a frog leg from witchery. I found that it only works if people keep IMing me on Steam.
Boto3798, the reason I am not using the Tiara all the time is because it uses quite a bit more mana than the Rod of the Skies, and I would like to let my Greater Band of Mana recharge. If I'm going to be just jumping over my wall, the Rod of the Skies does that just fine for me.
Sounds like somebody needs a mana mirror.
Oh, okay. Shadow Dragon's telling me that you have to be wearing the Goggles of Revealing for the arrow to show. That's a little annoying.
Ha!
That's
reasonable.
Not intuitive.
Yeah, it's not intuitive, but I guess it makes sense because the mod author also, the research and stuff doesn't show up unless you look.
I think
they
you
need
can
to tell
also
you,
just be holding,
No. No, okay. That doesn't work. Trust me, I was trying.
Thought I would suggest it.
Thank you.
Well, that would explain why it didn't work for me, and then it did, so, yeah.
It definitely does work with the items that are made from the Goggles of Revealing, because...
Alright, well, let's get to the Goggles of Revealing made, then. That's our best bet.
Good plan.
It's one of the first things you'd be doing, anyway.
Raxker's Fedora Raid? Interesting. We have some people coming in, it seems.
What?
I don't know.
Interesting.
People. Welcome raid.
Maybe. Fraxker showed up to tell me that Fraxker's Fedora raid is incoming, but it seems to be only be Fraxker.
Well,
it's a one-man raid.
One-man raids are the best raids. Especially
he's
if that one-man raid can actually...
nice.
Are
we doing Firelands as well?
Hey, I actually did that when it was current content. We got all the way up to Rag before on hard mode. That was fun. It was the
in
only fight that
version?
We did. No, not in a one-man version.
Oh, I was going to say.
During Kata, when it was current content. We had a lot of fun with that.
You mean you can't one-man raid current content? What's wrong with you? Are you just slacking?
I guess.
Oh, here's a nostalgia bomb for anyone who played World of Warcraft. MC Raiders.
Wasn't that a podcast or something?
No, I'm talking about the song.
Oh, I don't remember it. I was too busy writing MC.
Well, hold on, I'll dig out the link.
No problem, Boto 3798. We have a few more followers that I have not announced. Actually, we have a lot more. You know what? Everybody who's followed in the past half hour when I've been not paying attention, thanks for following. I'm terrible.
It's in the
this.
TeamSpeak chat.
Brain just paused. Oh, come on. Yep, it's gonna be one of those days. I've been fighting with the whole PlayStation 4 PSN integration thing for like 45 minutes before the raid started because I would like to do more with that later on today. Leather, thermometer, golden gate. Excellent. So, let's get some leather or more gold, and we will go make ourselves a thermometer.
So is there a reason for me to buy a PS4 yet?
No.
Bloodborne coming out on Tuesday?
Not really? Okay.
If you're interested in Dark Souls-style gameplay. The Last of Us Remastered, if you haven't played The Last of Us, is apparently really, really good. I'm looking forward to cracking into that. You're going to want to have either a PS4 or an Xbox One for Rock Band 4 later this year.
Ugh.
Or not. And if you're a Kingdom Hearts fan.
Okay, well, now you've got me.
Kingdom Hearts 3 later this year will be on both of the new consoles.
I thought they said 2017.
Oh, did they change it again? I swear that they've been talking about a this year release in the past, ever since like 2.5 came out.
I'm not convinced that they're not going to just go into Kingdom Hearts 3.5.8.
Hey, I'm really enjoying the collections, the 2.5 and such. Those are fun.
Yeah, I really want to try 2.5 just because it includes content that I didn't bother to get on
the game
platforms.
It's the game of the year dilemma. It's either you play it now or you wait until the inevitable DLC comes out and they collect it all.
Or you're a ridiculous fanboy for Kingdom Hearts like I am and you buy both.
Yes.
If you got the money, sure.
Well, it's the gaming budget is I can buy this game new, and then when the next one comes out a year from now, or a few years from now, because Kingdom Hearts doesn't release a lot of collections, by then, I'll have enough money again. So I need to get this wand filled up a little bit more. I need more Ordo. Where do I have Ordo? Probably in my pure nodes.
Another thing for the PS4 is you could count on the rumors of Fallout 4.
Yeah. Before we do that, we're going to hit up the basic information and we're going to research advanced node tapping. But maybe I should actually grab my scribing tools first. That would help.
I'll start saving up and just keep playing Hyrule Warriors for now.
Hyrule Warriors, I hear good things about. All right, so let's see. New followers that I still have on the list. We have, you know what? I can't even say your name there. You're like 2EBGD by stuffed. Sorry. We've got Billy Stars, we've got Enderston 129, Jal 12345, Yoichi Kun, Mitchkey 11, Sushi Boy Simon, welcome, Axel's Girl 13, Hollis Hiker, and Tree Roots 52. Thank you all for following. Alright, Aurum is already Precantatio and Air, and I've got a fair bit of Precantatio. I never know what, like, the proper paths are for research. I haven't studied it enough to know what the easy, cheap paths are. Wow. Devias, GMK Gaming, and Minwolf just followed back to back to back. Thank you very much. Vacuous and Potentia. So we need to connect Motus, which is Aaron Ordo. I wish I could get a Thaumcraft add-on where I could mouse over a aspect and see all of the things that aspect turned into. That's what I'm really missing.
That'd be nice.
Definitely.
Might be kind of tricky to get it so it didn't show that until after you researched those aspects, though.
Abudin and Butternotch, thanks for following. I figure you just make it a research off of the research mastery. Like, you have to finish research mastery to be able to get this.
That'd make sense.
Would make sense.
Does Ordo and Perditio make anything? Yes, permutatio. Oh, duh, I'm an idiot.
Good morning.
It's a horribly inefficient. Wait a second. Darn it. Oh well. This is why I use the cheat sheet. Alright, advanced node tapping, that's the one that doubles the speed. Right. If we want, we need node preserver for the good one. And master node tapping is also worth grabbing. Node preserver is the one that stops us from damaging things.
Very important.
Yes.
Yeah, I always go for that one as fast as I can.
Sorry, I was getting kebab. What happened?
Kebab has been got?
Yes, kebab has been got.
Probably the most, the biggest and best achievement you can think have at the moment.
Yes.
Unless you don't like kebab.
Then drink a bit more beer.
You're obviously not drunk enough.
Sounds like a good remedy to everything.
Well, you'll think it is at the time, Edenarian.
And depending on the quality of the kebab in question, you may or may not regret it in the morning.
Depending on the quality of the kebab, you may not have time to wait to regret it.
In the morning.
Well, here's a bit of advice. Don't go for the special kind of meat that some chip shops put forward on the menu. It's generally a bad idea. If it's not done, don't bother.
I usually figure if the person making it is reluctant to tell me what they put in something, I probably don't want to put it in my face.
Good plan.
See you later, folks.
Hey, Doug.
Later.
Bye.
Later, folks.
Take it easy.
Oh, yes. Try to access NEI.
User disconnected from your channel.
Nope.
Yeah, anytime we have to reconnect, I just go ahead and restart the client. It saves a lot of time.
Yep, because you're gonna end up, it's gonna knock you out.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was good the whole time you were fighting. I didn't once touch an NEI.
And I'll repeat the same advice I've given people several times now. If you're having that problem a lot, which we are, using multi-MC instead of the FTB launcher is a lot faster to get restarted because it doesn't have to go through the whole cycle check that it does.
That's fair.
Partly depends on how many third-party packs you have in your launcher, that kind of thing, but mine takes like 2 minutes to let me actually do anything.
And then that very last face is going to be the very face.
Last face.
Darn yeah. You, Devias! I'm trying to read and speak, and when I start speaking while I'm reading, I end up saying what I'm reading. He was saying that Purple has a serious business face on while researching. Yeah, generally.
Hmm.
I'm almost out of tea. That's a bad place to be. Yeah. Hmm. All right. So note and jar is something that we'll definitely get into another time. Right now, I just wanted to be able to siphon things off of the nodes that I have unlocked faster and more safely.
I spent like 4 hours cutting myself with an endless repeat healing wound just so I could avoid the jars.
That's fair.
Get teleposed instead.
Teleposers aren't bad. And they are actually a little bit better for some things. Huh, I thought the master research would allow me to siphon off the... Nope, it doesn't let me... It still doesn't let me get the compounds. The compounds can only be used by certain special devices. For example...
Yeah, there's one...
The one charging core.
I remember from Resonant Rise that let you drain from compound nodes if you had the appropriate focus equipped.
Well, I know Thaumcraft at base has the bonus add-on for the wand recharger that'll let you siphon off compound aspects.
Yep.
Or you can just use a blood wand like I did and have it recharge from your LP.
I've got the battalion one.
Working up to it. Working up to it.
Yeah.
I will say this now because I accidentally did it. You do not want to make the living wood wand.
-428.
Because it is hella inefficient.
Okay.
It will drain your greater band of mana so quickly.
That's not a surprise.
Well, that just means you need more mana.
This is from the upgraded band of mana. It takes like 6 per aspect point from the durability, I think.
Don't worry, Dylan is dead. It'll be up. The fight part went very quickly. I'm now just expanding on some things and showing off the node tracker bit and building some robes so that the people on YouTube get a little bit more out of this and I get to stream a little bit longer before I have to go back and fight with the PlayStation again for a while.
Well, you know, you're not technically forced to go back and fight with the PlayStation. You could just stream more.
But I want to play Last of Us Remastered, and I need the PlayStation for that.
Well, I guess there is that.
And I want to stream Last of Us Remastered.
Enjoying that game is very good.
And now that we're far enough past it, we can get people in here that are interested in seeing it.
Hmm.
I can travel a lot faster over land using the Tiara without, than I can without it, Boto. So yes, I totally needed the Tiara. The, Rod of the Skies does its best, but yeah, can't compare.
It's basically the equivalent of strapping one of those helicopter hats to your head.
Yeah.
That makes me miss form. The tuberous jetpack.
That was a fun one.
Here, take this potato pack. It's definitely not going to go wrong.
Not at all.
Something terrible will definitely not happen to me. You, on the other hand.
Yes, let's just say that on that day, Agrarian Skies was covered in fried waffle potato waffle things.
Who's hyped for Agrarian Skies 2?
Is that a thing?
Yeah. The Alpha is out on the Cursed Client right now.
I'm more hyped Cursed for... Client.
Yeah.
Magic Farm.
You guys haven't heard about the Cursed Client yet?
The what now?
I'd heard about the partnership between FTB and Cursed, but I didn't think they were starting their separate launcher for it.
Yeah. That was always part of the plan, was there was going to be a Cursed launcher. And the beta version of the Windows client is now available.
Sweet. I may have to investigate that. I actually managed to miss out on all of the fun everybody had with Agrarian Skies because I was still having my Minecraft hiatus during that period of time.
That's fair. Agrarian Skies is what brought me back. User joined your
channel. Hello.
And then it's what got me on YouTube, and, well, now we're here.
Are we here?
Yeah, you can't leave.
Where are we?
I sort of gave up on my world, though, after the fifth time I had to restart the whole thing from scratch because the world kept corrupting.
We are here. Here is a city in Wisconsin.
It is?
Oh. I imagine
it is. There is a city called here.
Is there one called there?
Yes.
So you can be between here and there?
Yep.
Yes, you can.
Yep. I live kind of near Boring.
Yep, and there's also a city called Nowhere.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Well, I know that Boring in the... Is it the UK Boring and the US Dull are partnered cities?
Other way around.
Sungak is telling me to be careful because I'm not resistant to fire right now. Yeah, I'm not resistant, but I've got Terra Steel armor. I can pretty much swim in this stuff until my mana, band of mana runs out.
That's not even true. You'll totally bite. I've done so myself.
Oh, I will slowly take damage, sure, but I've got 50 magical food, and that will regen me faster than I'm taking damage.
Ah, granted. Oh, speaking of magical food, has anybody else run into eating in the Nether and getting gluttony shards for it?
Yes. That's how you get them.
I have.
That is hilarious.
I'm still kind of curious as to how you're supposed to get the lust shards.
There we go.
Well, you find a, yeah.
To get lust shards, breed animals.
I kind of figured.
Hello, Tharklok.
I'm just asking, because there's this blood magic item, which is basically a bondage collar for blood magic in Forbidden Magic, which uses them as a recipe clone.
Yeah, Forbidden Magic has some interesting items available to it.
Quotes, quotes, quotes.
Though I did get to meet the guy who makes Forbidden Magic while I was at PAX, and he's pretty cool. Spiteful Fox?
Oh, yes, yes.
I just like how there's one item in it that's explicitly screw you blood mages. Specifically the rapier of the Strix, which deals damage to the player and the LP network and prevents them from gaining LP.
Yeah, that's a pretty big middle finger to blood magi everywhere.
Although, considering how the typical blood mage gears up, that's still going to take a while to kill them.
Yeah.
Especially considering that the rapier only does one damage. And has warping 2 on it, next on it, so enjoy those Eldritch Guardians, which are probably now following you.
Yeah.
There. Can you actually get out from under the mushroom now? And this pig is holding a shard that I want and is not moving. I mean, it's swimming in the lava, but it's just standing there. All right, well, maybe I can just... Nope. Oh, well. I didn't need that shard anyway. Ah, what the heck was that texture bug? That was weird. Boy, Kalishtar's got a chip on his shoulder about FF7.
Oh,
it's all, don't worry, PM is a one-winged angel now. Only needs to feel fear prepubescent pretty boys. I actually quite enjoyed that game from as an adult when I went back and replayed it, because it was...
Yeah, Defense of Cloudy is a post-pubescent boy.
Huh?
There is that.
I said in the Defense of Cloudy, he's a post-pubescent pretty boy.
Yes, but it's also, if you actually dig into the storyline, there's actually a fun, if very hard to understand, exploration of identity and what makes you a person there. And yes, there's, you know, the very power of friendship ending to it, but still worth playing through. I mean, that's just what you get out of shonen. If you didn't like it, then why are you investigating anything even remotely shonen related?
Omni Slash is still badass though.
Yes. I'm really only annoyed because they retconned the ending to people not all dying.
I didn't think the ending was ever everybody dies. Oh, they will eventually. When Squaresoft really needs the money and are like, you know what, we're going to just make the best version of it that we can and sell it for a full price game. Yeah. It'll get remade eventually, yeah. I guarantee you.
I mean, they do remake it, hoping for a sequel that actually stops them making really, really questionable spin-offs.
That's unlikely.
Yeah.
They're only going to make the actual remake when they absolutely have to, when the money has completely dried up from the questionable spin-offs.
Yes. So, until the money dries up completely, you might as well just go ahead and prepare your body for Final Fantasy VII Birth by Sleep.
Although, if current trends continue, I guess we can expect more lightning.
Hey. One, Birth by Sleep rocks.
Yes.
And two, lightning is not nearly as bad as everyone seems to claim. And three, I'm a giant Squeenix fanboy here, so.
Can we get
aren't we all?
It's less than more, so though. Still going.
So that's why you want the PS4, is to get 15.
Actually, I'm not that worried about 15, to be fair, to be honest. It could be good.
Final Fantasy Tactics?
Yes, I liked Tactics quite a bit. I want to play Type Zero, actually. But maybe I should get that.
I'm only worried about 15 in so far as it looks heavily, heavily like an MMO. Kind of like what happened to Dragon Age 2. Like,
yeah,
it's going more and more MMO-like as it goes on.
Honestly, they did that with Final Fantasy 12. And it was controversial, but a lot of people really loved it. So
I really enjoyed 12 for that, actually.
Yeah.
It was good, but it's just the fine balance, if you get what I'm saying.
Mm-hmm.
It's a balance between having a single-player MMO and a single-player RPG.
I agree. Mm-hmm. I haven't seen enough of 15 to really know, so.
Nor have I.
Anybody happen to know where we actually want the tunnel to go in the Nether?
Oh, the Nether?
So,
what tunnel? Why in the Nether?
Does the Terra Steel Helmet of Revealing work as a V discount item?
Nope.
No.
Okay.
It sacrifices the V discount for the ability.
Well, oh, Nether there we go. Railway tunnels faster than overworld railway tunnels.
Okay, that's
cool. I thought
you
wanted to have lots to dig.
That's true, but, you know, I've already got this great big tunnel at Y level 8 in the Nether now.
Alright, yep, this is pretty
cool.
We're
all on top of each other, that's the problem with the Nether.
Yeah, but if you get a good someone out there, like, I know the portals, I can build everyone their own portal if that's what you guys need.
But the problem is, we've all got portals. They're all right next to each other.
Yeah.
Yeah, so we made the tunnel already.
Wow, I completely missed this one.
Turn the most to them anyway. Somebody keeps knocking a hole in the side of some of them.
That does keep happening.
Well, I find the teleports is easier than tunnels. Nether.
Yes.
Balok, can I seek your advice?
Of course.
Tharklok, yes. Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep is the one that came out on the Vita. Or the PSP or something like that, and now if you want to play it, you can now on actual console through Kingdom Hearts 2.5.
Which I'm really looking forward to.
Alright. It was a DS, like, way back in 2008.
Nope, it was never on the DS. The DS games are, the newest one, Dream Drop Distance, and the one where you played as Roxas, which was 358 over 2 days.
Oh, right, that one. Which one was Chain of Memories? Was that the...
That was the weird card game one.
That was the Game Boy Advance game.
Game Boy Advance, right.
Yep. Man, sorry for cutting you off there. You were asking Barlock for advice?
Nah. I'll message it through the text.
Okay. Sorry, I'm going to occasionally override people when I am streaming, so...
Your channel.
Yeah, no problem.
Or, at any rate, if somebody does, you can mute them.
It's design advice, anyway.
There.
Your chimney is finished.
Almost. That's what I want to have the advice on. See if it, how to actually tidy the last bit in.
Sungok, if you want to play Final Fantasy VI, you've got two options. You can go the less than reputable route and look into emulation, and I will talk no further about that right now. Or you can pick it up, I believe it's on the Nintendo DS right now. There's a version for that. There's also a PSP version.
It's also available on Android presently.
It's available on Android, it's available through the iOS, and it's available as, I believe, a PlayStation store on the PS3. So everywhere but Steam.
Just to be clear, we're talking about the one with Kefka, not the other one, because I know that around 3 to 6, it got weird with the localizations.
Okay, so the way the localizations happened, Final Fantasy 2, 3, and 5 never released in the US during the Super Nintendo era. So they rebranded 4 as 2 and 6 as 3. They also made multiple difficulty changes in both 4 and 6, did a bunch of censorship because Japan is a lot more okay with representations of the female body than the US is. We're a lot more okay with representations of extreme violence than Japan is, yes. Which is, it's weird. But
I would trade.
Yeah, but that's another that's another discussion for another day that I'm not going to get into right now. So they made the games easier and more digestible for the US market and rebranded 4 as Final Fantasy 2 on the Super Nintendo and 6 as Final Fantasy 3 on the Super Nintendo. 3/6 is the one with Mog and Terra and Kefka, Celis, Locke, Cyan, all of them. Edgar, Sabin.
The list goes on and on.
Because people will remember it as different things.
Mm-hmm. User was moved out of your channel. User left your channel. Kalistar, I don't think that Sora from Kingdom Hearts will ever have an awkward angst phase, just because, like, they already came as close to that as they could in Kingdom Hearts 2, but Sora is just too super happy I have no darkness in my heart to ever go there. Which is, you know,
literally, he has no darkness in his heart.
Mm-hmm. It's amazing.
Elsewhere.
Spoilers.
Spoilers that you have to go into extensive and pick the material for.
That's a fair point.
No, it's spelled out in Birth by Sleep. If you haven't played that, well, that's not my fault.
Well, you know, some of us don't have a PS Vita.
Well, no, but do you have a PS3 or an Xbox 360?
Actually, I have a PS3.
Kingdom Hearts 2.5.
I'm looking forward to it. I'm just not there yet.
That's fair. It is so good. I went and almost 100%ed Kingdom Hearts 2 again on critical mode because the original US release of Kingdom Hearts 2 didn't have critical mode available. So doing all the data fights was a lot of fun.
I remember beating my head against the optional boss in the Arabian Nights world for over a week.
Yeah, in Kingdom Hearts 1. Mm-hmm.
Anybody have any particularly fun feats from the original releases of Kingdom Hearts 1 and 2?
Fun feats? Huh?
Fun feats.
No, I play those games. I don't play for... Like, I know there's a bunch of people that go for, I am going to do this at the max, absolute lowest level I possibly can, and... That's not me. I go straight to level 100 before I bother with a lot of the optional stuff.
Oh, well, I do too, but a good friend of mine actually managed to take out Sephiroth with the basic Keyblade at level 35, which was impressive to me.
In the re-releases that have...
In the original release.
Yeah, I'm talking about... I'm saying in the re-releases with the... critical mode that's available, you can do that at level 1.
Interesting.
They have a level 1 mode built in. If you start critical mode, you start with a 0 XP ability that you can equip immediately. And of course, if you've played the game, you know that all of your hit point increases come from leveling up, not from anything else. So.
Really interesting. I will have to check that out.
One thing I really missed in Kingdom Hearts 2, I think it was, I've only played like two of them, was I really liked the gummy ship sequences from the first game.
Yes.
I think one of like three people, but yeah.
I thought they got made even better in the second one, so.
I don't remember them being in the second one, so I must be thinking of something else.
You could skip them, but they definitely existed, and they were pretty fun. And they would, basically, they were made pretty much like Star Fox 64 style ores. Star Fox, they basically became a much better rail shooter with a lot more thought and such built into them. So they were pretty cool.
Cool.
Even I just though, to be honest, spent the design too much time working. Building the... gummy ships.
That's fair.
The person speaking, the aesthetic wasn't that great for that stuff.
Oh, the gummy ship looks? Well, they had a specific unit. It needs to look this way, so.
Hello.
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 Hey.
One of my favorite gummy ships was just a cactuar.
That amuses me for reasons that I can't quite explain.
Aren't those the best kind?
Yeah. All I can imagine is one of the Final Fantasy X cactuars just zooming through space.
Yep.
Bashing throughout everything in its way.
That's pretty much exactly it.
With occasionally its arms and legs will rotate and thousands of missiles will just spew forth.
Lasers everywhere. Every single spine on the cactus is a laser.
That needs to be a thing. There needs to be secret gummy ship unlockables with special abilities.
That would be great.
Like make a cactuar and it gets 10,000 needles as its
attack.
Why do
I not have any squids here? Fine.
Because they're all at mine and Harry's base.
You know, there's something weird with the squid spawning. Like, you get none for chunks and chunks, and then suddenly you'll find 1,000 of them just swimming around.
Yeah.
I think they're organized. There's actually just squid union meetings.
Ah, okay. That makes sense. For certain values of sense.
To overthrow the land dwellers.
It's all plotted out by the squid union.
It's the reason why I do the or dictionary method. I put one squid ink in there, and then I start throwing in a whole bunch of the black powders.
And they can actually
in
craft.
What? Oh, in a
in a drawer.
Okay, that works too. But you can craft it out of dye essence.
Which is what I was about to say.
You sure? Yes, but then I said it first. Aha.
Well, fine then. You're a more awesome than I am.
Nah, I'm just a dude.
Yeah, well, you know.
Do I not have it? Oh, I have 13 barrels right there. I just made the same mistake a few episodes ago. I'm glad no one called me on it.
I heard just made the, and then that was it.
It's not working.
Wow.
The whole, floral black powder into better barrel with the ink sac in it.
No, I use the drawers.
Roll.
Yeah, the storage drawers, not the barrels.
The drawers are more permissive about it, I see.
Yep, for the ore dictionary.
Otherwise, Sumeric culture. Or dictionary.
Yeah, the converter always works, but...
I have a setup of drawers that are all of the dyes, and that includes bone meal and lapis, and I just throw them in there, and they become those items.
Neat. There we go.
I kind of wish that squid soul seeds were a thing.
I'd rather have cows personally, but that's just me.
Cows would be that. Useful.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, essence of cow a lot exists, more this, but
my house.
They're just not enabled.
Yeah.
Well, you're supposed to grow your cows the old-fashioned way with a runic altar.
Uh-huh.
Grow.
Okay. Oh, wow. Thank you very much there, Everlost, for the $10 tip. I will add that to the pile of, man, I really shouldn't have gone out and bought a PS4 when someone tipped half of the value, but now at least I can pretend that, you know, there's more coming in. I got a little overexcited, and there were, when someone was like, here, have a giant tip, because I want you to play this game for me. Okay.
Hey, look, a shiny excuse.
Yeah, yeah.
Those are the best
kind. That would have been me, anyway.
I'd probably get excited if somebody tipped me half of the cost of a PS3 also.
Oh, yeah.
I mean PS4.
I think I would get I'd get pretty excited if someone tipped me half the cost of a PS3, gonna be honest.
True enough.
Yeah.
Like, that's a big single tip, you know?
Honestly, actually, at this juncture, I'd be excited if anybody tipped me.
Yeah, I was about to say.
Oh, you.
I'd get excited if they tipped me.
I'm lucky you don't throw things in my head.
You. Poor, you know what? I can't even properly express how sorry I am for you on camera.
I do get tips every day, but that's just something that belongs with the job.
Yeah.
It's something mandatory here for some reason.
Weird.
Yeah.
Blaze doesn't seem to count for the bottle of enchanting.
Huh.
It's okay. I've got a bunch of slime seeds that I need to... Oh, wow. There we go. Ron, not Ron Hacker. Connor, another $10 tip. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I tell Apollo Cat that people, like, randomly send money in for me playing games, and occasionally, like, you guys will buy me a pizza or something, and she's just like, why? Why? I don't understand. It's like, I don't know. If I knew, I would tell you.
Combination of you're cool and we have terrible impulse control.
We have what now?
Terrible impulse control.
I don't know what that is.
Now, what, impulse when control? You say terrible impulse control, is that the ability to control when you have a terrible impulse?
If only. If only.
Yeah.
Not ringing any bells.
Oh, has anybody tried out a wizard's lizard yet?
What?
What?
New roguelike, a wizard's lizard.
A wizard's lizard?
No, I have not. I'm still trying to, like, my roguelike of choice, if I'm talking like... Well, are we talking a roguelike or a roguelite here?
Well, I would say probably closer to roguelite. It's essentially... Okay. A friendlier version of Binding of Isaac with no horrible things.
Oh, okay.
It's,
by
very
horrible
Legend
things,
of Zelda.
Do you mean gameplay or aesthetic?
I mean aesthetic.
That takes out half the point.
I was gonna say, Binding of Isaac without the horrible things is
I'm
not
just trying to imagine a one of those stereotypical Sugar Candy Land versions of Binding of Isaac. It's still terrifying.
No, it's not quite that bad, but you are an adorable lizard trying to save the wizard that you work for. Mostly with swords and killing things.
I'm just imagining a poor little child slowly becoming a candy abomination over the course of the game now.
That's actually kind of worse, honestly.
The dark side of Willy Wonka's Chocolate Factory.
Hanalith, the button on the typesetting table was me forgetting how everything worked and thinking I needed the button there, but that's for just copying a vanilla book.
Basically, so far my experience, because I just picked it up on the Humble Bundle yesterday, was it's basically like, if you imagine a game for people who are fans of like the Super Nintendo style Legend of Zelda games, or somebody who wants to play Binding of Isaac but doesn't want to feel horrible about enjoying it.
That's fair.
Trying to find anybody else who's actually played it at this point.
Nope, never heard of it. Though I do highly recommend, if you like Super Nintendo era games, Ori and the Blind Forest is an amazing Metroid clone.
Interesting.
Good to know. I was wondering about that.
It is so good. I did a live stream a couple of days ago on it, and I'm going to be cutting it into YouTube episodes when I have time to sit down and do a massive amount of editing.
The art style for that game is really pretty.
By the way, I think I've been made a priority speaker, so if I'm talking while you're talking, you will literally be muted and I won't hear what you say. So when I'm done talking, just, you know, say it again.
Wait.
So someone started with, how do you feel? And I have no idea what finished that.
Squishy. He feels squishy.
Yes, I have the squishy belly.
Okay, you were talking about buying you a pizza earlier, and all I could think of is Rune Wolf's thing where you have it set up on stream where they deliver food to you while you're streaming if someone buys you food.
Yeah, I have a treat stream set up.
Oh, I don't see those links.
Devias is asking me how I feel about RTS games. I like them, but I'm terrible at them. I picked up Grey Goo on a 50% off discount I had kicking around from one of the PAXs I attended, and really enjoy it, but I'm bad at it. Really bad. Like, I don't even bother going into the multiplayer. I'm so bad. I can't beat the PC, and the PC AI has been described almost universally as ridiculously weak and LOL worthy.
The online RTS community is bananas. That's all I'm gonna say on the matter as to why I don't actually play online RTS. They are crazy people. Really, really good, but also kind of crazy.
Yeah, and confirm.
Yeah.
Yes, Saffron, I know. We have a 7 Days to Die server, and I would love to play on it, but I've had things distracting me. By the way, do you folks have known, you patron folks know about the 7 Days to Die server, right?
I know of it, but I've never played 7 Days to Die. I just sort of bought it and then stared at it and went off and played more Hyrule Warriors.
Oh, all right. Well, it sounds like something I should do a stream of this week, then.
Yes.
Yeah, what he said, minus the buying it part.
All right.
I'm just picking.
No, you're accurate. You're right. You are correct, sir.
No, I saw Hey Yorkie buy 7 Days to Die and play it with some friends, and it just looked so awesome that I had to pick it up. And then I got distracted because video games.
You got distracted from your video game by your video games?
It happens more often than you might think.
Oh no. No, trust me, I know. I've been replaying through the Squeenix back catalog because Apollocat hasn't seen most of it. We were enjoying Kingdom Hearts together, and we set that aside when I hit a particular boss in Birth by Sleep that was driving me insane, and picked up Final Fantasy 13 because she's never seen it, and that's been pretty much in the PlayStation for a month now.
Speaking of which, name the boss that gave you the most trouble in 1 and 2.
In 1, definitely Sephiroth. He was a I can't use those words on this stream to accurately describe what he was in Kingdom Hearts 1. In Kingdom Hearts 2, it was definitely one, Lingering Will.
For me, just going off the main story.
Oh, main story. I'm talking optional bosses.
Yeah. Those are not the whole kettle of fish, which are specifically designed to be terrible to people.
Yes, and they do a very good job.
I was actually sad about Sephiroth
in 2. I'd say the final boss fight before you go across the door. I'm trying not to say much about it because spoilers, but at the same time, it's hard to talk about something like that without spoiling something.
Yeah.
But, you know, the final boss fight against, what's his name with the purple chest armor?
Yeah.
Yes. That one. That one killed me so many times, and after the fight, I couldn't remember how to get back up to the top of the...
Yeah, and if you've saved right before that fight with that guy, you can't go elsewhere and level up. You're stuck there. You have to just keep doing it until you beat it. So yeah. that fight is definitely a get good moment in the game that a lot of people hit a wall with.
And the second one, there were several, but I think one of the worst ones was the guy with the sitar.
Okay, yeah, the water dude. He was difficult.
What time you fight him?
I'll admit, I usually have difficulty with puzzles rather than with bosses, just because I have this compulsive over-leveling thing going on.
Fair.
Oh, actually, now I'm thinking about it. Forget the water guy. One of the ones right near the end when you first go into the final dungeon.
Forget that guy. He's not really
that
bad.
Dual pistols.
Yeah, actually, he was the dual crossbow pistols guy. He wasn't that bad for me because I had gotten really good at the reaction commands, and he literally never hit me for the entire fight.
Well, for me, he kept going into that mode where he changed the arena into a ring around himself and then annihilates everything around him. Mm-hmm. That thing right there killed me so many times until I found out that I could... If I timed it just right, I could stop it with Protect.
Yep.
Or was it Reflect? Or Shell? Whichever one it was.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, yeah, he was kind of nice until he decided, no, I'm gonna kill you now.
I don't remember exactly which one, but I remember Cerberus giving me such a hard time.
Wasn't that much of a deal with me, because in the Kingdom Hearts main series, I'm of the opinion if they don't put everything into arrow combos, then you're probably doing something wrong.
Oh. I had a very different approach. I tried to combo as little as possible because the final swing was always a critical hit. So I was always get all of the combo minuses you can and do multiple short attacks to do the most damage.
I was mostly doing it so I could charge my MP. I was of the opinion that the more I attack and get attacks, the more I can heal.
That's fair.
Sort of create a self-perpetuating loop of healing.
Well, you know, if you're focusing your strategy on healing, that means that your strategy breaks down if you don't get hit.
Well, no, because the way the MP rate works, from what I recall, is that it depended on how much damage you took. So if you completed a combo and they retaliated with one big attack, that's basically half your mana bar back. And if you'd be hitting them back...
And the first one, yes. They actually fixed that in the second one because it was too easy to stay fully healed all the time.
Yeah.
UB365 and Ron Hacker, thank you for the follow. I may have gotten Ron Hacker before, but now I've gotten you again. I need to start building a better node.
You should actually stop by our base and see how we've built a bigger node.
Oh, I've got my own plans for it.
Yes, but your plans must be corrupted by knowledge of our plans first, otherwise it's just not okay.
Okay.
I'm currently idling when mine grows.
But it's a lot more fun to execute my plans with no knowledge of what everyone else is doing, and then get a bunch of you commenting on the video saying, I really wish I knew about that 3 weeks ago.
I guess that's fair.
Hello, Azure Vacation. How you doing today?
Okay, according to my Arcane Abacus, I have a node with 77 Air, 72 Terra, 71 Ignis, 69 Aqua, Ordo, 67, and 71 Petitia.
I stream at bad times for everyone, Ash.
I need to feed this thing more nodes.
Oh, this setup is so lovely. Presently, I'm staring at our node, which has 115 Aqua, 66 Terra, 91 Ignis, 25 Ordo only, 167 Predicio.
That's probably a lot more than you ever need.
Yes. 58 Air, and 61 Tutamen, which is the best part.
I'm specifically growing mine to be energized, so I'm just going to be stopping it around the 9 part, where it gets around to 9 for each.
Yeah,
H1
then.
I'm not 100% certain you need that much. That's all.
Oh no, this is,
Well, for me, yes, I actually kind of do. There's a lot of the automatic stuff specifically runs off of entropy.
It's true. Oh,
My point is that you guys are building one massive node to try to power your entire network on. But you could build a bunch of little nodes that only had 3 of each a lot easier and make multiple networks.
Yep.
Because to get 9 power out of one big node, you need 81. But to get 3 power 3 times, you only need 27.
Which is really fast, yes.
Yeah, the first 2 I got were 5 both, just without doing anything.
So, I get big numbers, no kill like overkill, but sometimes there's actually a point to use something a little smaller. Just a little.
Well, I mean, yeah, we have, for instance, just like, there's no reason not to just stick a single energized node on top of your infernal furnace. But there's something to be said for having some fun with building a terrifying node.
Mm-hmm. As long as it's not, like, harming the server to do it.
Oh, no. No, what's harming the server is my,
Benson would look like an unlike show.
If anything I'm doing is harming the server, it's just my mana battery that's harming the server.
I mean, if you have to do a ton of exploring, you're gonna, cause issues.
Oh, no, nothing like that.
Alright, you know what? I gotta turn this thing back on. I've used all of the mana during those enchants. Alright. Time for all of the Endoflames to activate at once.
Yay.
You see, I haven't tried growing a node because, well...
There we go.
I just posted an image of what happened the last time I did it in the group chat.
What happened the last time?
Well... for those of you who can't or don't look at the image, it's basically a humongous storm of wisps.
This is the image that they're talking about.
Oh, I clicked away to the wrong screen. Let me take a look here. Oh, wow. What in the world?
All of the wisps.
Those are all wisps, and it was like that for like 12 chunks in every direction.
How did that happen?
I was on a multiplayer server with like 6 or 7 other people, and a bunch of them started using this was in 1.6. They started using one of those moving frame node relocator things, and somebody had a tainted node they refused to get rid of, and between shoveling a bunch of nodes back and forth and bullying each other, and it you can see the end result. But as a result, I've been a little shy of touching the nodes because I don't want that to happen again.
So, to sum up, mistakes were made.
Oh, yeah.
But think of all the Silas Mundus.
Yeah.
There is that.
Like a Boss and Shinzos and UB365, thank you all for following. Oh, boy.
If you recall, back then it was kind of a big thing.
Why is my elven gateway off?
Why
was it even on?
Out of power?
No.
it was possible. Maybe.
No, it's not that.
Did spark death or something?
Oh,
guys, I occasionally have problems with that.
That's the wrong wand. That's not my Botania wand. That's my Mystic Branch. Those two things aren't the same at all. What in the heck did I do with my wand?
They're very twig-like, though.
There we go. Wand of the Forest. That's better. Pardon me.
I don't know why I... Like, how has someone not created a input the... like a web app for the research where you can just slide the aspects into place and hit solve? There's tools that will find you combinations between two specific aspects, but like to be able to fill this in as it is on the screen, that would be great.
Yeah, my stream keeps crashing, so I can't see it.
Oh, Geert, I know. I linked that exact one earlier today, so.
Okay, I love it.
I admit, I actually got tired of using the research helpers just because the research helpers don't know what I have sitting around in my storage with way too much of.
Oh.
So I just started...
You can specify in the GitHub one.
It just requires extra
of
work.
You can blacklist certain aspects, which is generally what I do with auto because way too many of the research notes use auto.
Yeah. I find that as long as I can just teach myself to turn everything into Arbor, I can use as much Arbor as I want without ever running out. And so just converting everything into air and wood and connecting it is more efficient than connecting things as quickly as possible.
This is terribly inefficient, but I do this every time I research something. I reach a point of I don't care anymore and just finish it.
Perfect. That's honestly more effective than some people imagine. Just finishing it is frequently better than spending time looking things up.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to be muting myself a bit because animes.
Hooray, animes!
Yes, Durarara and Lock Horizon have updated.
Ooh, so, I need to get... That? I just picked up... canceled my Pandora and picked up a Crunchyroll subscription specifically for Log Horizon. We haven't actually started it yet, though.
Yeah,
I can't speak to the second season. First is really good.
I got given a extra 14-day trials for it randomly, so I'm mooching off of that at the moment.
I made the mistake of loading up Kill la Kill one day. And
how
I
was that?
You know, honestly, and I hate to say this, it's actually really fun. And I don't know if that's because my brain has been warped by the experience or not, but it did less damage than Fooly Cooly. How about that?
Well, that's something. Very little, because Fooly was really, 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 really weird one for you. Only watch when you're exceptionally, exceptionally bored or on drugs. Or both.
What, FLCL?
Yes.
Yeah.
Also, under that same sort of pile is Serial Experiments Lane.
Oh, yeah, and yeah, I've watched and enjoyed Lane.
Yeah. That one's weird.
Yes. Yes, it is. It's just, honestly, Lane is a lot easier to understand if you learn a little bit more about the culture that it came out of.
Yeah. There's a couple of others I'm thinking of. Like, one with the random guy with the baseball bat and skateboard. And every time you get hit by him, you suddenly feel better about all your problems. For some reason.
Nice.
They don't actually explain why.
We are approaching 2 hours of upstream uptime. I'm probably going to be logging off in about 10 minutes here and back on later today, where you might see Apollo Cat and I on the couch playing Last of Us Remastered together, which is going to be hilarious because she doesn't do horror games. And I know Last of Us Remastered isn't like super horror, but yeah, it'll be good.
Yeah, I think my favorite co-op horror experience so far was actually Resident Evil 5, surprisingly.
Talking animes, quick question. Does anyone know if Sword Art Online Season 2 is done yet?
Yes, it is, and the first half is the only one you really need to pay attention to. Because Out of all of Sword Art Online, the Gun Gale Online section is like passable, and so long as you actually have a working knowledge of the first season. But the rest of it is just filler, unnecessary filler.
Yeah, they completely destroy the equality in the relationship, and they turn what once was a fantastic female protagonist into a damsel in distress.
You see, I've watched the second season, and I don't agree with that, actually. Not entirely. I get
Maybe
where you're coming from.
Because I stopped watching?
You need to... So, okay. They're... At first, it really seems like that's all they're going to do with it, but then she manages an escape scene that goes pretty well, and her actions are the only thing that allow the hero to do his job. So it's a collaborative effort.
Like the sound of that. How deep into the season is that? Because I might be able to suffer through.
It's the last few, and it does get really squicky and gross, but it doesn't explore so much making her a damsel in distress as it explores a very powerful person put in a position of helplessness and still doing everything they can to fight their way out of it.
I'm not talking about the first Aincrad, but just for reference, I don't think he is either.
Huh?
From what I'm hearing, that's all season one, isn't it? The split between season one.
The Sword Art Online, then Aincrad, then there's Gun Gale Online, and then back to Aincrad for filler.
Oh, okay. Never mind then. I thought season one was, season one was Sword Art Online, and then season
Sword
two.
Online, season one was a two core. So it was like 24, 25 episodes.
I remember that the way it was presented to me, because I watched it on Netflix, was that Sword Art Online was the first segment, and then, like, saving her from the fairy land was the second.
And the tentacle monsters.
Yeah, but
right.
That's...
Right, they broke it up into story arcs instead of seasons, basically.
Oh, okay. So then I'm talking about the second part of season one, I guess, but...
As am I. I was right there with you.
Okay. Then yeah, what I'm telling you is I've seen through the end of the segment you're talking about, and she, if it were not for her actions, then he would never get to her.
I will definitely consider choking my way through the rest of it then.
All right.
Like I said, the Gun Girl Online pop, actually, okay.
Okay.
By all accounts, even if you don't like this first season that much.
Worth getting into. We're probably getting into territory that's a little too spoilerific, because that stuff's a lot more recent than the other, but yeah.
Fair enough.
Okay. What was I doing? I was going to finish this research and then log off.
Yes.
Actually, wait, what do you mean? I've got COD Bobro
segment because of Britannia. And to clarify, one of the flowers has an entry in the Mexicopitania, which for some reason has the caption Asadistan repeated over and over and over again. So
oh no.
Google
Wait it. A second here. Wait a second here. Everlost, what have you done? Are you here? You have to be here.
I'm in voice chat, yes.
You... So apparently we're getting a chicken bacon and ranch pizza because of Everlost. Make this a link on your Twitch, lol. It's on the description page.
You mentioned it, so I had to do it.
That's fair. That's fair. All right. Well, I guess I'll tell Apollo Cat to not make dinner.
You need some healthier delivery options.
I know, we don't have a whole lot in the area, and I haven't set things up in detail yet. I tried to get them to do the local sushi place, but the options were out of their price range, so.
Yeah.
So, I need to work on that. So I just picked our two favorite pizzas out of that pizza place.
Sounds reasonable.
They're also really good.
Well, yes.
Now you can get Apollo Cat to help you fight the PS4.
Yeah. Brain, shut off. Saint Bibin, I have not received a notification for stream tip for you just yet. I have Connor and Everlost having sent in tips. I will go and check stream tip right now. I'm doing so to make certain that I didn't miss something, or that T-board didn't miss something. But yeah, I only have Everlost and Connor. If you set up to donate by Patreon, that is a something that does not happen until the end of the month. You wouldn't be able to anyway, Connor. There's a 6-hour cooldown on that. And yeah, I'll definitely do some research on making that a little better.
Otherwise, I could see you doing a stream and all of a sudden you have like 30 show up one day.
Yeah.
That would be funny.
Actually, people used to do that. Like, they would order a whole bunch of pizza to deliver with, you know, cash on delivery as a way to troll people.
Yeah, bet trolls.
Mm-hmm.
Does that set it up for a 6-hour, or do you set that up for a 6-hour?
I did.
Okay.
I get to decide.
That's what I meant. That would be hilarious.
I think there's a default, but yeah, I set that one up. Oh, there's the automated alchemy.
I think what would truly be hilarious would be if somebody gets trolled with the 30 pizzas and then actually whips out a roll of cash and pays for them.
Codbo is asking if I can give an estimate on how many hours until I'll be back on. I honestly cannot. I wasn't planning on doing a PS4 stream today, and in fact I didn't think I was going to be picking up until Monday or Tuesday. We just happened to be out that way and Best Buy had it. So if I do one, I will do my best to put up a notification on both YouTube and Twitter beforehand. And it'll be just a few you know, it won't be a really long advance notice. Sorry. Just how it be. Alright, shut this down. Wow, I kind of like the fact that I can refill a mana pool in like 15 to 20 minutes, so.
Have you played around with the Lunium? And trying to get the enchanted overgrowth seeds?
Not yet. It's on my list. I want to build even better mana production than this before I get into that. And I've got a couple of ideas for some more systems that are going to be golem fed and a couple of other cool things that I want to do before I start spending mass quantities of mana getting those.
I recommend looking at Akka the Builder's Golem Cake Pantry videos. He made an entire golem setup with automagy. To make cakes.
You say this like I don't follow Echo on YouTube and watch most of his Thaumcraft stuff. He was the one that taught me how to Thaumcraft 4.
How to Thaumcraft 4?
Yep, because he had the whole like full walkthrough on it, I believe. And I think that he was the one I learned blood magic from as well.
Yeah, most blood magic I actually learned from Belgabor, who couldn't be here today because I think he's LARPing or something.
Oh, that's cool.
And
we've got got quite a vibrant local theatrical LARP scene in Albany.
Yeah, I forget where in Germany he's at, but he has a lot of fun, and every now and then he posts pictures that look like they're having a lot of a good time.
Do they do theatrical or boffer over there?
I don't know. I haven't even thought of asking.
Okay. I know a little bit about it because I have friends, local friends in the scene. So, Nope, that's not my followers page. Zencrad, thank you for following. Also, Crane and Rum123. Yes, Rum and Coke would be good right now. All right, we are at 4 p.m. I am going to go sign off and warn ApolloCat of impending pizza. Thank you again. Thanks for joining me, folks. We're going to be back sometime this evening in the next 3 hours. No guarantees on exactly when. I'll put up a YouTube video announcing it and a tweet. So follow me on YouTube, follow me on Twitter, follow me here, get notifications, and I'll see you later with PlayStation 4 and The Last of Us Remastered. Also, you'll finally get to meet Apollo Cat live in the flesh.